Hello dear friends, this is Dr. Dipesh Patel and I'll be teaching you jet propulsion and aircraft engineering. Today in this video lecture, we are going to see a lecture 3 of solid and liquid propulsion engines. And in this video lecture, I'm going to cover the heat transfer consideration in rocket motor design and liquid propellant rocket. So let's begin with the heat transfer consideration in rocket motor design. Now, since rocket is having very high temperature in combustion chamber, the heat transfer is one of the most important aspects that need to be considered. And even the overall heat transfer in rocket motors is quite complex by considering the motor design task. Furthermore, the release heat from the motors is very high, and even the thermal loads are extremely large inside the combustion chamber, and therefore the thermal insulation is frequently necessary required in the motor combustion chambers and the nozzle, because it has to face a very high temperature. Now, heat transfer to walls can affect a rocket in at least two different ways. The first one is reduction in the performance and creating a greater difficulties in the design of hot side structure. The principal modes of heat transfer to nozzle and combustor walls are by convection and radiation. From these two, the convection dominates, and radiation stands to be also important for particle laden flow from solid propellant rockets. Rocket motors never reach thermal equilibrium during their firing. The temperature of all components exposed to the heat flow increases continuously during operation. In good thermal design, the critical locations reach a maximum allowable temperature in a short time after the motor stops running. The nozzle components rely on their heat absorbing capacity and slow heat transfer to withstand the stresses and strains imposed by the thermal gradients and loads. The maximum allowable temperature for any of the motor materials is just below the temperature at which excessive degradation occurs. Now, the operating duration is limited by the design and the amount of heat absorbing and insulating material pieces. The rate of heat transfer from the combustion process to the liquid oxygen flowing in the channels is adjusted so that most or all of the liquid oxygen is vaporized and the combustion chamber wall temperature remains low. So heat transfer is one of the important aspects that need to be considered during the overall design of the rocket motor. Now let's move forward to the next type of the rocket engine, which is liquid propellant rocket engine. And it is shown in this slide over here. You can see the main components are basically two different tanks to store fuel and oxygen, then pump for each tank, control valves also used for the each tank. Then we use the preheater, as we discussed in a previous topic. The preheater is required to start vaporize, to make them vaporized before it reach to the combustion chamber, and then we use the injector, which actually mix the fuels together, both of them, fuel and oxygen or oxidizer, and then inject it into the combustion chamber where the combustion process takes place. So the liquid fuel, such as like refined petrol, liquid hydrogen or hydrazines, and liquid oxygens are used in this engine in two separate tanks. So they both stored in two different tanks. Preheater is used to heat the fuel and oxidizer before it reaches the combustion chamber. And nozzle is used to increase velocity and decrease pressure. Now let's understand the working of the liquid propellant rocket engine. Liquid fuel and liquid oxygen are pumped separately into a combustion chamber through the control valves, as you can see in diagram. Since the liquid fuels and liquid oxygen are stored at very low temperature, they are preheated in the preheater to a suitable temperature, right? As we want to store them in a liquid form, basically they are stored at very low temperature, so that need to be preheated before it need to be injected into the combustion chamber. The preheated fuel oxidizer mixture is injected into the combustion chamber through suitable injector, and then combustion takes place. When the combustion takes place in the combustion chamber, very high pressure and very high temperature gases are produced. The highly heated products of combustion gases are then allowed to expand in the nozzle section. In the nozzle, pressure energy of the gas is converted into kinetic energy. So the gas is coming out from the unit with very high velocity. Due to high velocity of gases coming out from the unit, a force or thrust is produced in the opposite directions, and this thrust propels the rocket. So this is how the overall system works. Now let's go through the advantages and disadvantages of liquid propellant rocket engine. So first of all, let's start with the advantages. The first advantage that liquid propellant engines can be reused after recovery, and therefore it is economical. The combustion process is controllable since it is easy to stop the combustion by closing the fuel valves or oxidizer valves, which was not possible in solid propellant rocket engines. Then speed regulations, like increase and decrease of speed, is possible. Furthermore, it has a high specific impulse as compared to solid propellant rocket engine. Even the malfunction and accidental can also be rectified at any stage. So these are the advantages. Even the liquid propellant rocket engine is mostly suitable for the long range operations. So these are the different advantages of liquid propellant rocket engine. Now let's go through the disadvantages. The first disadvantage is that liquid propellant rocket construction is more complicated as compared to solid propellant rocket, since it has a more number of parts, it has a more number of moving parts. So the overall construction is a lot more complicated as compared to solid propellant rocket engine. And by considering more number of parts, the overall cost of manufacturing is also higher as compared to solid propellant rocket engine. The third disadvantage is that there are additional handling and safety problems if the propellants are poisonous and corrosive. So therefore, transportation and handling of propellants require greater care. Next disadvantage, the size and weight of the engine is more compared to solid propellant rocket, since it has, by considering more number of parts and even the overall dynamic issues are higher, and therefore the overall size is a lot bigger, and therefore the weight of the engine is also more as compared to solid propellant rocket engine. Then next disadvantage, high vibration because of the more number of moving parts. And the last disadvantage is that many liquid propellant can exist in liquid state at very low temperature. So therefore, proper insulation is required for both tank and the feeding line. So these are the disadvantages of liquid propellant rocket engine. So that's it for this video lecture. If you have any doubt, you can write down in the comment box. Thank you very much.